Mark Rober is going to hit 20 million subscribers, and to celebrate this, I turned one of his best videos into a game. I'm going to Portugal next week, which means I only have 8 days to make it. Fuck! First things first, I need to choose a video I'm going to be turning into a game. And the one I chose was the Squirrel Parkour because... Squirrel? Now that we have a game idea, it's time to make a project. And first thing I added was a cube, which is going to be a player. I then added more cubes to make the layout of the map, but I didn't only make cubes, I also added a beam. With the layout done, it's time to make the models. But before we do that though, I should probably tell you guys about the map layout. In the video, the only place a squirrel can climb up is this platform, so in the game, this is your starting point. The first obstacle the player will have to pass is the Bridge of Instability. Which looks easy, but as Mark explains it...
The trick is, it attaches at a single point on each end. And from a physics standpoint, that makes it no different than trying to crawl across a tightrope.
After crossing the bridge, you end up in the maze of 1,000 corridors. In the video, it's just a simple maze, but in this game, it's less simple. If you manage to find your way out of the maze, you will need to pass the pitch for tumblers. Unlike in the video, they don't care if you're stuck between them, so if you get stuck between them, well...
Sucks for you!
If you manage to not get squeezed by the tumblers, you have to make it past the home worker. No, not that one. Although... Anyways, if you stand on the platform for too long, the floor will rotate, making you fall forever, at least until you respawn. Then we get a problem. The slinky. Damn you, slinky! I can't think of any way to simulate this inside of Unity, but... Wait a minute. Zoom in. Enhance. Go back a few frames. Huh. In the video, they don't actually use the slinkies to go to the next platform. They instead just jump. Which means I don't actually have to simulate the slinkies. Thank you, squirrels. Very cool. On the next platform, you will find the part of the obstacle course that took me the longest. The tourist trap. On this platform, you can find a big wall with a hole in it, and you can put your head in it. Wait, no, not that one! So, if you put your head in it, you can take a picture.
Here we are, at last. We have finally reached it, the second to last obstacle.
The second to last obstacle are the quad steps of great elevation. The cubes are angled at 45 degrees and have almost no friction. So, the only way you can make it past it is to take your time. And by taking your time, I mean run! And if you complete all that, and manage to not fall, you get to the final obstacle, the squirrel pulled. So, apparently I forgot this part, so if you complete the quad steps of great elevation, you have finally completed the course, and you get to the Fort Nuts. But as you can see, Fort Nuts is nothing more than a cube right now, so it's time for, as Mark calls it...
Put it all together in this 20 second build montage.
It's time to replace the cubes and implement the mechanics. But before we do that, we need a skybox. For that, I used an HRI from HRI Haven. For those of you who don't know what an HRI is, it stands for High Dynamic Range Imaging. And I definitely didn't look that up on Google.
I smell bullshit.
What it does is, it gives me a background and lights up all the objects in the scene correctly. The first obstacle is
the Bridge of Instability,
which I make work with a hinge joint, which makes the object rotate around a certain axis. To cross this bridge, however, you need to move, which currently isn't possible. So I made this quick moving system, which I replaced later on because this one is garbage. For the maze, I needed to add jumping, so I added that and it worked perfectly. Yep, definitely worked first time. After exiting the maze, you get to the pitchfork tumblers, but right now it's just pitchfork, not tumblers, I guess, I don't know what the fuck. To make them spin, I just wrote this piece of code, and it works. For the ejection pad, I used the same code, and it works like a charm. Oh, come on, what the fuck? When you land on the tourist trap platform, a text pops up telling you to press the interact button, get into the frame, and when you press E, the player itself gets disabled, and a different model pops up with a head that I definitely made first try. The player camera also gets disabled, and a new camera gets enabled, which gives you the illusion that you just popped into the frame. I made it so when you scroll the mouse wheel, you zoom in and out by changing the field of view, and when you move your mouse, the camera moves, and it does not work at all. I had to change the camera to an orthographic projection instead of a perspective projection, and the main difference is that an orthographic projection, you have no visible depth, which sucks, but it's the only way I could make the camera movement work. Doing this, however, breaks the zoom feature, so I had to change it from scrolling to pressing a button to zoom in and another one to zoom out. The last thing I had to add was the ability to actually take pictures. For this, I found something on the internet and stole it, I mean borrowed it. Thank you. I don't really know how it works, but like Albert Einstein once said, if it works, you don't need to know how. Bro, 2021, colorize. That was a lie. He never said that. For the quad steps of great elevation, I just made a physics material of which I lowered the friction, and after which I added it to the quad steps of elevation, and now it's slippery. When you complete all this, you get to Fort Nuts, where you get a windscreen, and the time you actually took to finish the course, as well as your high score. I added a timer and a pause menu, which doesn't actually pause the game. It just shows you a pause menu, because I don't really have any time left since I have to edit this video. I also made a menu. That's it, thanks for watching, be sure to subscribe, and if you want to play the game, you can find a link in the description to download it. Have a great day, evening and night, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!